15 minutes past the hour of 4 o'clock here on KTLR, and this either could be a guest or it's the Wheel of Fortune. Let's go ahead and see who we got. KTLR, who do I have here?
Oh, hey, it's Murky calling. How are you, Rusty?
Oh, diamonds the size of walnuts. How is your chest cold?
Sorry?
I thought you had a chest cold. Okay, well, never mind.
No. I'm calling in from the Not Even a Show doing the cold open for the new season. And basically, it's like an SNL theme. Usually for their cold opens, they have a political theme, but I don't want to do that. We want to keep it non-political. Basically, I just need you to say, let's start the show, and then we can start this year off with a bang.
Oh, I'm a little frightened, but yes, go ahead. Let's start the show with a bang.
There we go, Rusty, you did it. Everyone's going to love you for it.
Oh, my gosh. Hell yeah. Yeah. You got to love that.
Sorry if you thought it so, but this is not even a show.
It's NEAS Saturday.
Folks, there's a new kid in town. SNL is going down. There's no need to give us thanks. Just tune in and watch the pranks. Yeah, one call, a two call, a three call, four. Just when you think we're finished, then we call once more. You're in a little battle and we're fighting a war. How can you stop the pranks when we're pranksters to the core? It's NEAS Saturday night, yeah. It's NEAS Saturday night, yeah.
Your musical guest, the Bare Naked Ladies. And your host, Ryan Luttrell.
Hello, everybody. No, I'm just kidding. It's me, Brian Luttrell from the Backstreet Boys. Very, very excited to be hosting the season premiere of NEAS Saturday Night. It's safe to say, I suppose, that Brian's back. All right. No, I'm just kidding. But in all seriousness, we have such a jam-packed episode for you. You're just going to absolutely love it. They've got calls to Jesse Lee Peterson, Sebastian Gorka, Roger Stone, Alex Jones, JJ McCartney, and a new show called Just for Fun Radio. First things first, though, the prank stars managed to get their hands on Ian Miles Cheong's phone number, and so they did a little bit of long-distance prank phone calling. Check it out.
Hello?
Yep.
Hi, is this Ian?
Yeah. Who's this?
Oh, hi. It's Jason calling. I got your number from somebody. I had information. I live in Seattle, Washington, in the United States. And I had some information regarding Antifa, Black Lives Matter. And somebody pointed me in your direction, said you might be interested, might be able to disseminate the information better than I could.
Mm-hmm. I mean, who is this? I mean, I'd like to know, like, who's speaking? You said Jason? What's your last name? I mean, how do I know you?
Oh, well, you don't know me. I will admit, I mean, I know you just from, I follow you on Twitter and so on. But I am a private citizen. My last name is Buckley, so Jason Buckley. I could provide more. I mean, I don't want, you wouldn't be using my information if you were to mention it, would you?
Right, yeah, I wouldn't put your name in there, yeah, for sure, yeah.
Okay, but yeah, would you be interested in the information? I mean, it would be verifiable, I think, probably from other sources. I would just be a starting off point, the information I would give you?
Sure, yeah, I mean, sure. I mean, go ahead, what's up?
Okay, the information I received is that you've never had sex with a girl before?
Did you seriously call long distance just to say that? That's pretty fucking funny. I hope you recorded this because that's gold.
Yeah, but you know what's also gold is being a grifter who doesn't actually...
It's a perfect time to call. Somewhere far away from y'all. I've got some info for this dude. I promise that I won't be rude. There's a group called BLM, and I have got info on them. So open up your ears. This is something you wanna hear. Post all day about the world like you know, then you have to jack your little brick. That's how it goes when you have never even left your front door.
Jesse Lee Peterson is one of the most homophobic people in the world, which is why it was slightly notable when he was found to have liked a post on Twitter for a gay OnlyFans site. Now, as soon as he was found to have liked this post, he locked his account, and so we decided to call him and do a little bit of investigative journalism. Check it out.
But 4 more years for the great white hopefuls. Otherwise, you will live to regret it. Jason is a first-time caller out of Seattle, Washington. Jason, welcome to the show. You're on the air.
Hey, thanks for taking my call, Jesse. How are you doing this morning?
All is well, sir. How are you?
I'm doing great. It's interesting, when you played that clip of Trump, I came in late to it, and I thought it was a new clip, and I honestly got excited, Jesse, because he sounded so, like he had so much, you know. But he doesn't sound like the same man nowadays. Can you agree with me? He sounds kind of like a beaten man now when he's doing his rallies compared to the clip that you played from January 2017.
You're right. He sounds stronger now, more confident.
No, he sounds less strong, I think, now. It makes me a little bit worried.
Do you have hearing aids?
No. Okay. My question for you.
Hold on, Jason. Jason, don't hang up. I got to take a quick break, all right? I'll come right back to you. He sounds stronger now than ever after beating the Chinese virus. Let me go back to Jason. Jason was
impressed how strong the president has gotten over the years.
Jason, a first-time call out of Seattle. Thanks for holding.
No problem. My question for you, Jesse, was did you lock your Twitter account because you got caught liking a gay OnlyFans post?
Amazing. Do you think I handled my own Twitter stuff?
Oh, somebody else did it? How come you locked the account?
Lockwood. None of your business. What the? Are you a homosexual or something? What the?
No, but it doesn't really matter.
Why are you such a beta male? What, you know all that stuff that's going on is not real. But you being a girl right now, what making you be a girl right now?
There's nothing wrong with it, Jesse.
There's nothing wrong with you being a girl.
They were in.
Goodbye. Amazing.
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 Let me go to Tayshawn out of Ohio. Tayshawn, welcome to the show. You're on the air. Tayshawn.
In the first year of NEAS, the Fap Master famously phoned and jacked off to Roger Stone when he was hosting on InfoWars. Now, the Fap Master's done a lot of self-reflection over the years, and he's realized that some of his actions are inappropriate. So he called Roger Stone's cell phone to make amends. Check it. Oh, hey, Roger. It's Fap calling. Hello? Can you hear me, sir?
Yes, I can.
I spoke with you when you were on InfoWars with Owen.
Are you just calling in for a good time?
I am having a good time jacking off, yeah.
All right, well, that's...
you know what? Go ahead and dump that, too. Let's go ahead and dump that.
I'm just trying to... I was batching off to you at the time, and I've been going through some therapy and figuring out that's not a good way to be, so I was just calling to say sorry and make amends.
That's fine. I don't recall the incident, but if you say it happened, that's fine.
Yeah, I was calling and you were hosting InfoWars, and I was batching off because you were wearing a 3-piece suit and it looked really good.
And but I'm being told I shouldn't be doing that. I should not be batching off to people when they are not saying that's okay.
Well, don't worry about it. All is forgiven, okay?
Appreciate it, Roger. Sorry about all the legal stuff.
Gotta go. Bye.
Seb Gorka has really become a white whale for the channel, as he's using lots and lots of his show's resources to keep us off the air. And he's been very, very effective with it, as it's been some time since we've been officially on air, but we will. And in the meantime, we still do get to talk to him. Check it out.
Hey, Brad.
Hey, how you doing?
Good. I've got back-to-back guests for the rest of the show, so I'm not taking any more calls, but thank you for calling in.
Well, thank you, and can I say one thing before I go?
You may.
Well, do you use a tablecloth for a bandana because you have a giant head?
Brad. Why are you envious about how large my appendages are?
Do you have a small penis?
No, all my appendages are average. I just want to know if it's troublesome for you. With your large head,
Brad,
to get a bandana
jealous?
If you have to use tablecloths or maybe
jealous,
a king-size sheet from
Brad,
a bed.
Before you give your phone back to your mom, why are you jealous?
Mom, he wants to talk to you.
Go get him,
Mom. He wants to talk to you.
Come on. Get her on.
Hello? Yes, do you use a tablecloth for a bandana?
I thought he was going to go woof.
Hello? Yeah.
Wolf shot.
Do you use a tablecloth for a bandana?
Who's giving it, Brad? Where'd you get the script? Yeah, who's giving
Mom,
you the script?
Mom, get off the phone.
Despite Joe Rogan's best efforts, Alex Jones is absolutely washed up. So after his big interview with Rogan, we decide to give him a phone call and try to set up our own little interview. Check it.
Hello? Oh, hey, Alex. I got your number from Joe about writing a piece about you, perhaps?
Hey, who's
there? My publication? I'm calling from a publication. My name's Ken. I got your number from Joe, and he said that maybe he'd be interested. We were going to write a piece on you. My publication was going to write a piece on you.
I'd love to talk to you, brother. If Joe says you're a good guy, I bet you are.
Yeah. I work for Has Been Magazine. Congratulations.
Has been. That's a good one. I want to be in that.
You make me sick.
Yeah, well, you're going to be the feature story, my friend.
Thank you. I look forward to it. All right, well, send me some info. Thanks, man.
Ever since he lost his best friend, Tom Gully, tech head Terry has been in search of a new best friend. He's had a couple of close calls, but nobody's really stuck. Well, I have a feeling that's about to change. As tech head Terry called two of the biggest tech heads we've ever dealt with. Check it out.
Hey, hang on. Let me see who this is. Don't hang up. Hello, who do I have? Hello?
Hello?
And it basically, it's millions and millions and millions of video templates, music, sound effects, all that stuff.
Let's talk about this after the show, and let's get back to being stupid. Before we got 30 minutes, some of my people will start going, oh my God, is this tech talk? So let's keep it moving. Live, who do we have? Who do we have?
My name is Terry.
Hey, Terry.
Long time listener, first time caller?
Well, yeah, I can hear you. What's going on?
Not too much. Yeah, you couldn't hear me last time. I was talking. I was saying, hey, it's Terry. And you guys kept saying, hello. Yeah. And I was like, oh, no.
These damn phones, dude.
Yeah, we
could
hear you.
Technology sometimes, man.
We could hear you. We just didn't want to answer.
Now, that's interesting that you bring that up, sir, because that's the reason I called in. I'm a little bit of a tech head, and the song will play now.
Terry loves tech.
No, it did play, though. I got my own song. I have my own shirts now as well. People can get Tech Head Terry shirts now and everything.
Terry loves tech.
Yeah. So I love what you guys got going on. You're showing off your OBS. Someone was asking in the chat what OBS is. That's open broadcasting software.
Yeah,
one of the two industry standards. The other one would be Streamlabs OBS, so that's SLOBS, they like to call it for short, right, fellas?
You see, that's what's so funny, because, like, people look at me and go, this son of a bitch knows nothing about tech stuff. And I'm like, I have I'm dyslexic, and I've forced myself to learn every single bit of this to do what I do. Like, I'm a funny person.
You guys respect tech. I talk so many of these shows, and they don't respect tech. Hey, what kind of mics y'all working with?
I changed everything over to the Evo. EV, sorry, my brain. I'm thinking motorcycles all of a sudden. I changed everything over to EV, and these I think are the 320s. Because what I started looking at is these 320s versus, now these 320s are right around that $300, $400 mark. But when you start looking at the $1,000 microphone that they make, this has actually better ratings than the $1,000 microphone. These are more durable than the $1,000 microphone.
That's what I like to call a tech value, baby. That's a tech value.
Yeah, man. Woo! And they're black, and they just work so much better. Some of my people start going, oh my God, is this tech talk? So let's keep it moving.
Let's be honest. You can have kind of crappy content. You can have crappy talent. You can have crappy video. But you know what? The one thing that your crowd will never, ever forgive you for is bad audio.
Can't have crappy
you
sound.
You can't have a podcast. You can't have a
listen, you can talk about the stupidest things.
Oh, that sounds good.
We start talking about
what
tech.
What kind of headphones y'all working with?
I allow everybody here to kind of go through different stuff. A lot of our people want to wear earbuds.
You gotta get uniformity. Yes. You gotta get uniformity. I know.
He can't have any blinky lights.
My problem is I have a $200 set of Audio Technicas that I love. Mike's wearing the first pair I ever paid like $80 for back 8 years ago. Some of my people start going, oh my God, is this tech talk? So let's keep it moving.
These are actually mine over here.
But the problem is when I bring in $200 sets of headphones, I got to worry about people tearing them to hell up because that's happened a million times.
Hey, some people don't respect tech. I agree with you. Some people will just run right through it. Well, I'll tell you what, fellas. I call a lot of these shows. I love to talk to tech and everything. But I got to say, this was like the Super Bowl for me. You've made a little boy about as happy as can be. And the audience is going to love it as well. And they're going to have a whole lot of respect for you as well.
And then see, I'm a radio station first and foremost, by the way. I'm fixing to celebrate my 10 years on the 11th of next month.
Can I get a Terry Love Tech?
Hey,
Terry
plug tech. Everything on how to find you. Tell everybody that's listening to our show exactly how to find you.
Well, you found me. I'm here.
No, but
how did you find us?
Yeah, how'd you find us?
On the internet using technology. Bye.
Oh, my God. I wanted him to plug his page and everything.
I've been posting on these Facebook Live group pages.
They love shirts here at the Not Even a Show, and so it only stands to reason that they would now be selling shirts. And you can buy one. The link is in the description of this episode, and we would love it if you bought one. But we would love it even more if a certain someone else bought one. And that man is a man who's dealing with the worst technical issues I've ever seen on a live stream. The shirt boy himself, JJ McCartney. Check it out. Rocking better shirts than you. Loving
the JJ crew. Somebody calling from area code 317 is on the line. Hello, who are we talking to?
Buy my shirt. Please buy my shirt.
JJ Snap, JJ Snap.
Nice try. Nice try, but no sale. Bye-bye. Bye-bye now. See you later.
Honestly, the schemers out there trying to weasel their way onto the show. We're not going to fall for their crap. And quite honestly, 7 days away from an election, I mean, who do you think is bankrolling them? Who do you think is bankrolling them?
JJ Snap!
All right, folks. If you would like to call us, 9215-815545, 21915-458-55.
Well, that's the end. Unless you want to head over to the Patreon tomorrow morning, Sunday morning, we've got Pranks to Meet You with Marnie and Marty, calls to Dennis Prager, Todd Starnes, and a tailgater call over there. Patreon.com/NotEvenAShow. Well, I'm just so grateful to have been given this opportunity. I wish I had more to say, but I don't actually know or remember any of my songs other than the Backstreet's Back one, so I don't really have any more references to make. But thank you for supporting, and we're back and we love you. Bye.